wake up and I'm opening the windows. I look out my bunk window and I see that thing parked right there. Well, hello to you too. That's a truck. Look at that thing, it doesn't even fit in the frame. Yikes. Maybe he's got a kitchen in there, a bathroom in there. Probably got like a king size bed in there. Who knows? I would walk around and show it closer to you, but the guy's in the window. And the windows are open. That'd be weird. And we gotta get going. We gotta deliver our freight. So this beautiful piece of engineering that we're traveling over right now, and that beautiful skyline off to the right there, and that odd pyramid to the left, belongs to Memphis, Tennessee. We're just leaving West Memphis, Arkansas. It's the Memphis that's west of the real Memphis. Guess that makes sense. What is that pyramid thing? Why do they got a pyramid in Memphis? I didn't know they had pharaohs here. What in the world? Where are we going? Are we going the right way, Diesel? Yeah. I-40 East. Mandy's not talking to me, so that must mean I'm going the right way. What a beautiful city this is, eh? Memphis, what is this, City of Rock or something? Memphis. Yeah. Isn't this where Elvis was born or something? Great city. So we're going to the east side of Memphis. We're gonna drop some freight off there. Let this car in here. I don't know if he needs some room or not. Oh, I moved over for nothing. He had a lane. Okay, well, now they're not gonna let me back in. I don't wanna be in this lane, four-wheeler, so I gotta get out of this lane. Gotta get out of this lane.
1.7 kilometers. Take exit 1E on right to I-240 south, then keep left.
Okay, I-240 south. That's the way we're going.
That is a good breakfast.
Right, Diesel? Maybe. Maybe not.
We're just here in Memphis, waiting to get unloaded. It's one of those hurry up and wait situations. Hurry, 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 hurry. We want this freight yesterday. We get here, you'll have to wait. I see. That's just how it goes. That's just how the industry goes. It's always, always hurry up and wait. Better to be here early or on time and wait than be late. Where's that driver going? Here's a driver messing around over there. Don't take my door, driver. Don't take my door. I'm waiting for one driver to pull out. And then once he's pulled, oh, there he goes right now, actually. Then I'll have my door open and then I can back into the dock. I guess I should get ready to back into the dock.
Driver tried to steal my door. I had to go and let him know, hey, it's my door. He's like, oh, I don't usually have to wait. I usually just back right in. I was like, oh, well, there's a lineup over there. See those like 5-6 trucks over there? Yeah, we're all waiting. He just cut right in front of everybody and tried to back into the door. Oh, well, he wasn't mean about it at least though, so he had a good attitude. But he's getting out of my way now.
All right, so finally got into the door there, got everything figured out, got unloaded. Now we are in Mississippi. I don't get to come down to Mississippi that often. We don't have as much freight going down here. We're gonna be crossing through Alabama into Georgia. Alabama I go to even less, so it's kind of a special day. Get to see two states that I hardly ever see. We're going right through Birmingham, Alabama.
Poor guys, for the life of them, can't get those things undone.
Oh yeah, sure, why don't you just drive right in front of me here and ruin my shot, that's okay. They were tugging, you know, one guy had one side at first and the other guy had the other side. They were tugging, I was waiting for it to break apart for them to both go flying in each direction. So we're here at Love's Travel Plaza. We
haven't stopped at Love's very often in the past, so I'm not very familiar with them. But I've now got the go-ahead, or the, what would I say? They've told me that we're getting better prices on fuel at Love's. So I figured, I'm gonna start fueling at Love's. They're giving us cheaper juice. Yeah. So now I'm fueling at Love's in the States. I'm still stopping at Flying J Pilot. Because it's just, they got a better network and, you know, I got their internet there and whatnot. So in the States, it looks like I'll be fueling at Love's now until Flying J decides to give us better prices on their fuel. See how long this lasts, but yeah. Just waiting here a little bit and then I'm gonna be going and doing my first transaction. It's kind of exciting.
Our first ever fuel up at Love's. Who's that? The trust factor. I trust that you have diesel fuel in there for me. Is that what you're talking about? Who knows? Love's.
Why do they call it Love's Diesel? Or maybe a guy who is in love with a woman did it, man. Maybe that's why.
I don't know. Why would they call it Love's? Why would they call it Love's?
I don't know. Anyways, we're gonna see how good their fuel is today.
All right, I think we can figure this thing out. Wait a second. Oh, already not impressed.
Hashtag not impressed. I hate biodiesel. Why can't we just burn diesel?
Why does it always have to be special diesel? I know why the reasons are, but seriously, this gums up your engine and your injectors, and it freezes in wintertime. The reason my fuel gels so easily is that. I'm not sure what the biodiesel blend is in Canada, but I'm pretty sure it's not between 5 and 20%. I'm trying to figure this thing out. I've even got my own Love's reward card. Let's see if it works. What do you want? Well, this is exactly like Flying J. It's like no different. No, we do not want DEF ever. Skip that junk.
Those guys got it in. Noisy engine fan. Truck number. So it seems like it's exactly the same setup as Flying J and Husky. They're all the same. I wonder if they're all the same, like all together. It's a conspiracy. One company owns everything. So we're just leaving Love's here. The overall first impression is good. The store was clean. The parking lot is nicely paved. Nicely taken care of. It's clean. Not a lot of garbage lying around yet. I say yet because it'll happen. The pump system is exactly the same as Flying J and Pilot. So that was easy. The reward program, I'm not too familiar with it yet, but I did read up on it once and I know they got a pretty good reward program. So that's good. So I'm just broadening my fuel stops. I used to stop at exclusively Pilot, Flying J. Because with our fuel cards, that's where we were getting the best prices. And now that we got Love's on the list, they're giving us better prices like I was telling you, so. Why not? You will win my business if you offer me the cheapest product, as long as it's still the same quality, right? And I'm pretty sure all the fuel comes from the same place. I do understand the whole reason for the biodiesel and the DEF, like don't get me wrong. I'm just not that big of a tree hugger like that. Yes, I love being in nature. I love nature. And I understand that these things are making or saving that. Doesn't mean I have to like them. They make things a lot more difficult in the wintertime. In summertime, all of these things are fine. Every single person I see out here is talking on their phone and driving. You see that guy too? And they're all driving nice cars too. I guess they can afford the ticket.
Alright, so this is Birmingham, Alabama. Birmingham, Alabama. And I don't know why we're not going. Lights are green here, my friends. Green. Green means go, at least where I'm from. Alright, here we go. Now they get it. Alright, all right, here we go.
Take ramp on right to I 20 east.
You bet, Mandy. That's what I'm gonna do. That's a good idea. I'm gonna do that. So I've been eating a lot of fruit lately as snacks instead of, you know, junk food. It's amazing how much better you feel having an apple instead of a candy bar. You know? Just saying. The doctors always say that, you know, that, yeah, but you don't always believe it, right? I'm saying it's true. You have some fruit? Oh, it's like having an energy drink without the crash. I feel great. We're going around this little loop to doop here. This will spit us out onto the I-20 East. That's what Mandy said, right? And we might, hopefully, get a good look at downtown Birmingham. We get a decent view. I'll share it with you. I've noticed the roads around here, though, need a little bit of help, though. They're still better than some places I've been to. A little bit bumpy. That's okay. That's what suspension is for. All right, let's get it wrong. Go, 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 go! Time always comes every day when the vlog's about to end and everybody goes, oh, yay! Diesel, Diesel. You want to explain to everybody what we do when we stop? Well, let's go over what we do, see if we have time to keep this in the vlog or if I have to edit it out. If I have to edit it out, I'll just do it tomorrow. Anyways, so we park the truck, right? First thing we usually do is pull the shades. And that turns my whole truck into a giant sleeper. Instead of just having from here back a sleeper, see, this whole thing is now a home. And no one can see and have total privacy. Which reminds me, I still gotta put the cover on that window. Whatever. Do that in a little bit. At least this one. It blocks the light from coming in. It also keeps the cab cool in summertime. It doesn't keep the cab warm very well in wintertime, though, having that there. But it does keep the sun rays out in the summer and keeps your cab cooler. Anyways, sun's not up now anyways. So when I do stop, my logbook is kept down there. I grab it, I put it on the steering wheel right here, I do my logs. First thing, as soon as I stop, make sure everything is good to go, make sure it is all true and correct, I sign it. I put the white copy, the original, into an envelope. Right behind it there, it even says logs on it. And I put the yellow copy, which is my copy, into a separate folder. That stays with me, goes to my accountant, my mother. And so, because you get tax credits for every log sheet that you hand back in, right? Because this is how it works in Canada anyways. I'm not sure how it is in the States. The more logs you hand in, the more returns you'll get, right? I think that's how it works anyways. I don't know, I'm not the accountant. Mom will correct me if I'm wrong. Anyways, first thing we do after we're done our logbooks, we take all of our cameras. First off, all this junk gets gathered here throughout the day. Take our cameras. This is the one that goes on the mirror. Take that, you put it back here. Not right beside that, because that's getting hot right now. And the camera from the dashboard, you go like this, and boom, there it is, I was hiding. I haven't done this yet, usually this is my routine. And then the camera I'm holding right now is my best camera. It's the most expensive camera I have. I like it because it's awesome. It's just very awkward to carry around. It's very obvious what you're doing. Anyways. What's my other camera? Oh yes, and this is my other camera. This is my regular vlog camera that I always have in my pocket everywhere I go. And when it's not in my pocket, because it's uncomfortable to have that in your pocket when you're sitting, right? I have this little holder here for it. Boop. And that is my regular vlog camera. Just fits right in your pocket. Just a Sony PowerShot. It's what most vloggers use, from what I've heard. I find it to be great because you can just, like I said, just slide it in pocket and it does great HD video. It's got a little bit of a zoom, though it's kind of annoying because when you zoom in, you can hear it in the audio on the video, but that's a great vlog camera. And it's very affordable. I think it was only like $183 or $160 Canadian, as opposed to the camera I'm holding right now, which is like, how much was it, $700 or $800? I got it on a deal because it was a demo, so I paid considerably a lot less. But brand new, yeah, that would be a lot. And then those GoPros are, the white edition, I think, is, what is it, 200? 200 or 300? And this is the black Hero 3 Plus. When it was brand new, it was $500. That little thing. And then all the accessories are like, this was like $20. No, I think this was more than that. I think this was $40 for this thing. GoPro accessories are not cheap. They know they can just give it to you, because you can't get those accessories anywhere else. You have to buy the GoPro accessories so they can charge whatever they want, right? So once I get all of my cameras together, I pull out my handy dandy thingamajigger here. This is my computer bag, which is all in a mess because I'm a messy person. Where is it? Where is it? Come on, I know you're in there. I just put you in there. 1 second. Can I put you on hold? I need some good hold music. Where are you? Found it. Put it in the wrong bag. You don't belong in there. You belong in this bag. That's my clothing bag. What are you doing in this? You're supposed to be in my computer bag. This is what I use. Some of you are using, wondering, what do I use to transfer the files? This is a USB port, obviously. Plugs into the computer. And this is a universal plug mount. See how, like, almost any kind of plug can fit in there? Mini SD card, regular SD card, any kind of SD card just goes right in there. Put the files onto the computer, which is already over here on its little cooling pad. Getting ready, booting up. I put all the files on there. If I have time and energy, I edit it right away before I go to sleep. If I'm too tired, or if I just don't have time because I'm in a rush, I need to pretty much just go to sleep so I get the rest I need so I can get up right away. That usually happens in Canada because you can only stop, well, you only have to stop 8 hours per night in Canada, right? Then you account for the other 2 hours throughout the day. Hard to explain right now. That's not what this clip is about. I'll do that another time. But that, in those cases when I'm in a real rush in Canada, I won't even edit the vlogs. I'll just put it onto the computer, put it into a file, close it up, and edit it when I get a chance. It's pretty much a benefit of having the vlogs a little bit behind. And then what I do is I worry about supper. Today, supper's gonna be the same as yesterday. We got this George Foreman grill. It's brand new. It's the second time we're gonna be using it. We're gonna eat the rest of the chicken breasts that I have before they go bad. And potato salad. Pretty much same thing that we did yesterday. And this is my home, guys. So as you can tell, it's very homey. It's got pants hanging everywhere still because I still haven't folded them and put them away because they're hanging to dry because I washed them like 2 or 3 days ago. No, they're not in the way. They're chilling there. And then this is all my junk. It's not my junk, but the Jets bag in the back there. Go Jets, go. That's my dirty laundry bag. All my dirty laundry goes into that bag because it's the biggest. And then once all my dirty laundry is washed, it turns into my clean laundry bag and I bring it back to the truck. This bag here underneath this nice little YouTube mouse pad is my socks and underwear. And, you know, Advil and Tylenol, whatever else I might need on the road, stuff like that. This is my computer bag for all my computer accessories, including the cooler. And then the computer has its own little case there as well. And I don't know what that is. I don't know. I just give it to Diesel. He seems to like it. Dog food. Forgot to buy dog food last time we were at Walmart. We're going to have to stop again before we get back to Canada, man. Anyway, so that's when I go to sleep. All of this stuff here gets moved onto my driver's seat and steering wheel, pretty much. And then I have the whole bed free. I put it all over there on purpose because I want Diesel to stay off of this side of the bed. That's where I rest my head because that's usually the highest point because you're usually, you know, against the curb. And that's the highest point. I put my head there. I know Diesel sheds and it doesn't bother me, but it does bother me when I'm trying to sleep and I have a mouth full of hair. I don't like that. No offense, Diesel. No offense. I love your hair. But that's why that's all there, to keep him off of that. So then when I put that there, I have a nice, clean, hair-free place to lay my head, right? And then he has his pillow over here under my mat. and that's where he lays and he can look out the window, because it works out better that way anyways, right? Because he can just lay there and stare out the window while we drive. And that's that. Anyways, this thing is heated up, ready to go. I'm starving. Starving. So, I'll see you guys tomorrow, 4 a.m. Central Time. From here, we're going to be going, delivering our freight into Buford. We're in Brazelton, Georgia right now. We're going to be going into Buford, Georgia, dropping a pallet off there, one or two pallets. And then we got one pallet left, I think, or two, whatever. I got three pallets on the trailer right now. Two are going to one place. You know what I mean. After we go to Buford, unload there, we're going to, oh, somewhere in North Carolina. Where? Oh, no, Mount Holly, North Carolina. That's where we're going. We're going to drop a pallet there tomorrow. And then we're headed over to Kinston, all the way on the coast, I believe. We're picking up a load there, and that's taking us up back to Canada. And you'll have to wait to hear about that load when we pick it up. Anyways, guys, thanks for joining me today. I really appreciate the views and that you're so kind to me with all the good comments. I read them all. Believe me, I read them all. I don't have time to respond to them all, but I read every single one of them, and you guys have been great lately. You know, you've been great all the time. All the time. What am I saying lately? Lately, it's just been better than usual, I guess. So, guys, if you like the vlogs, don't forget, there's that like button down there. It gives me a big boost of motivation to make another vlog. And other than that, I'll see you tomorrow. 4 a.m. Central Time, or any time after that, the vlog will be live. What do you want, Diesel? Why are you sitting so close to me?
I just want you to know, you're my favorite human. And that chicken smells really good.
Delicious. What would you think, Diesel? Does that look good to you? Mmm, that looks good. Good boy. God, boy, no, you still can't have it. But I will give you that little chunk right there. I saved you that little chunk. Yeah, but it's a little hot right now. I can't give it to you yet. It's too hot. Good boy. He won't touch it unless I tell him to. If I gave the word, he would swallow those things whole. One bite, all of them. Not until I tell you, though, right? Those are mine. I'll give you that piece. Good boy.